Welcome back. I'm your math teacher, Jeevita. In today's class, we are going to start with a new chapter, lesson number 3, Factors and Multiples. So, today what we are going to discuss in this lesson is, we are going to discuss what are multiples and we are going to discuss about divisibility test. So, let's start. First, we are going to learn what are multiple. The question itself you can see here, multiple means multiplication. Multiplication. So if I take any number, example A, and I ask you to find the multiples of A, then you should multiply 8 with 3 numbers, right? Like if I multiply with 1, I get 8. If I multiply with 2, I get 16. Multiply with 3, I get 24. With 4, I get 32. And goes on. So what are the answers which I got here? These are called multiples of 8. So multiples will always be equal to this number and more than this number, the number which we keep, but it will never be less than the given number, because starting itself you get the number here, and as you go, the numbers are increasing it and number is not decreasing. So multiples of a number will always be equal to or greater than that number. So now you just write it. Multiples means nothing but multiplication. And if I give you a number 7 and ask you to find the multiples of 7, same thing, you multiply with different numbers and get the answers of it. And that will be the multiples of 7. Now if I ask you to find the multiples of 7, particularly the fifth multiple, the fifth multiple of 7 means multiply 7 with 5. 7 times 35. So this is the fifth multiple of 7. 35 is the fifth multiple of 7. So this is about multiples. Now next we will be going to divisibility. Now let's go for the next part, that is divisibility test. So you all know about division, you learned in the previous chapter. If I ask you, divide this by 5. Yes, I would. 5 2 10, 5 9 45. 9, my right answer is 29. Now let me take another number and I ask you to divide by 5. 5 2 10, and do you get 43? No. So 5 8 40. And 3 is remainder. Now I don't want my remainder. If there is a remainder like this, I don't want to divide it. I will divide it with some other number. So if I want to know whether this is will be divided by a number or not, we have some few tricks to know that. I teach you today the what are the tricks. Okay? So divisibility test is mainly used to find whether number will be divisible or not. Divisible means you should get remainder 0. You should not get remainder like this. So whether a given number will be divided by this number or not, like that you are going to check. So now I am going to teach you some tricks wherein you will be able to find whether the number will divide or not. First, divisibility. First one, I am going to check with 2. That means I give you a number and will you able to tell me whether I can divide this number with 2 or not? Yes, you can tell it very easily, because 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Remember this number here. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. If you have any one number in this, then definitely that number will be divided by 2. You can see 8. Yes, 8 is in the unit place. So this will be divided by 2. You can divide it with 2. You get 0. Let us take an example of another one. Now tell me, will this be divided by 2? No. You can see 3 here. In one stick, you have 3. You have 3? No. You should have 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. If you have any one number in this, in the unit place, only then it will be divisible by 2. If you don't have that, then this is not divisible by 2. This is divisibility test for 2. Now let's go for 3. For 3, you should add all the numbers which is given and check the answer will be divisible by 3 or not. Like, let us take the second one here. What is the number given here? You should add all of them. 3 plus 1 plus 0 plus 3. 3 plus 1 plus 0 plus 3. Now add them all. 3 plus 1 is 4. 4 plus 0 is 4. Plus 3 is 7. Now 6. In 3 ones are paper, do you have 7? No. So this cannot be divided by 2. Sorry, 3. This cannot be divided by 3. So let's take one more example. Now add all the things. One plus six plus zero plus zero plus two. 6 plus 1, 7. 7 plus 0, 7. Plus 0, 7. Plus 2, 9. So my answer is 9. You can divide 9 with 3, right? In 3 ones that you have 9. So this number will be divided by 3. You should add all the numbers given. Check the answer will be divisible by 3 or not. For 3. Now let's go for divisibility of 4. So for 4, let's take an example and explain. For 4, you should mainly concentrate on last two numbers here. So last two numbers is 32. 32. Say 4 on the table. Do you get 32 in that? Yes, absolutely. 4, 8 times 32. So this number is divisible by 4. So let us take one more example. 15 here. So 15 is in 4 on the table? No. So this is not divisible by 4. So how do you check the divisibility of 4? You check the last two numbers and that is divisible by 4, then the whole number is divisible by 4. If it is not divisible by 4, the number is not divisible by 4. This is for 4th one. Next we go for table 5. That is 5 on the. This is very easy, children. You should have 0 or 5 in one place. Only then the number will be divided by 5. See, 2 is in one place. Can it be divisible by 5? No. You have 0 here in one place. 0. So it can be divisible by 5. Yes, it will be divisible by 5. Again, you have 5 in the unit place. Yes, so this also can be divisible by 5. So this is divisibility of 5 tables. Now let's go for divisibility of 6 tables. For 6, you don't have particular idea to check, but if it is divisible by 2 and 3, it should be divisible in both 2 and 3, then it will be divisible by 6. That is, must be divisible by 2 also. It should be divisible by 3 also. Then Original. Let's check. Check for two tables first. You have 6 in the unit plane, so it is divisible by 2. Now let's check for 3 tables. We should add all the 3. All the 3 numbers. 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 plus 6 is 9. So 9 is absolutely divided by 3. So the number 156 is divisible by 2 also, divisible by 3 also. So if it is divisible by both, then it is divisible in 6 also. Because it is divisible by 2 and 3, this is divisible by 6 also. This is about divisibility of 6. Next, we go to divisibility of 9. For 9, just like 3 tables, you should add all the numbers and check whether it is divisible by 9 or not. So let's take an example. 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 plus 5 is 8. You get 8 in 9 of the table? No. So this is not divisible by 9. Let's take the same old example which we took now. Add all this, you get 9. And 9 is divisible by 9. In 9 more than you get 9? Yes. So the number 126 is divisible by 9. So just like we were the even 9 more than you add all and check for the answer. So next divisibility is for 10 tables. That is very, very easy, children. Unit plane should have 0. Like this. It should have 0 in it. It should have 0 in the unit plane. If it has 5 or anything else apart from 0, then it is not divisible. It should have 0 compulsory. Next, divisible by 11. This is a little tricky, but it is very easy. So let's see with an example. I'm going to take an example of number 1331. 1331. So children, for 11 divisibility, what you should do is you should keep count numbers. Means I'll take the first number, I'll not take second. I'll take the third number. I'll take these two numbers, add them. What is the answer I get? 4. Now I'll take the next number here, which is left. Second and 4. What is the answer I get? 4. You can see both the answers are same. If you have the answer like this, then the number is divisible by 11. The number is divisible by 11. If it is not, let us take one more example. This is the second example. I am going to take the first and the third number. 2 plus 6. 8. Now take second and the fourth number. 1 plus 4, 5. Did I get both answers same? No. So this number is not divisible by 11. So let us divide the divisibility once again and we will conclude it. First, divisibility of 2, you should have 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Any one of these numbers in the unit plane, then it will be divisible by 2. For 3 tables, add all the numbers and see the answer whether it is in 3 on the table. If it is not in 3 on the table, it is not divisible. For 4, you should check last 2 numbers. Last 2 digits in the number. If that 2 digits is divisible by 4, then whole number will be divisible by 4. For 5 tables, in unit place you should have 0 or 5. For 6 tables, the number should be divisible by 2 and 3. If it is divisible by both comes in line of the table. For 10, you should have 0 in the 1's place. Only then it will be divisible by 10. For 11, add alternating numbers and get the answer. Next, add the leftover alternating numbers, get the answer. If you get both the answers same, then it is divisible 11 or not. So now let's